Today I'm house hunting in the rural region of Abruzzo in Italy. Its rolling hills, olive groves and vineyards make it the perfect location to find the quintessential Italian country property. I'm Jasmine Harmon, and over the last decade I've helped hundreds of people find their dream homes. We've spent this summer travelling around Europe searching for gorgeous houses at great prices in popular summer sun destinations. We've found that the property market is changing fast. As Spain, Italy and France recover, things are hotting up. And for the first time in many years, some agents think this could be the start of a new house price boom. Are they right? Stick with us and decide for yourself. Today's house hunters are Ali Harris and Steve Ashby from Poole in Dorset. Inspired by a shared love of Italian food and culture, they want to move over here permanently. They're looking for the perfect rural Italian property to transform into a boutique B&B over the next 5 years. Ali and Steve first met 20 years ago at work, but it wasn't until years later, when they were both going through breakups, that they got together as a couple.
We're good support for each other, I think.
Yeah, we back each other up. And she's my mate as well.
One of the many things Ali and Steve found they had in common was a passion for Italy. Now they've decided to move out there and open an upmarket B&B.
It was just an idea for our retirement, somewhere that we can both grow old together.
Ali is keen to run the kitchen.
Ali's a great cook. My guys, where I work, always want the food that Ali cooks, or mainly the cakes that Ali cooks.
Steve has 4 children from 4 marriages and 3 grandchildren. Ali has 2 grown-up daughters. With finance from the sale of her home in Ascot, the couple are hoping to create a home from home for family and friends, as well as paying guests.
And Abruzzo seems to have it all. It's got a really nice coast, it's got the mountains.
We want to spend the rest of our lives together, and what better place to do it than Italy?
Lying in the centre of Italy, Abruzzo is a land of rugged mountains and gorgeous beaches, much of it untamed and wild. For centuries, very few outsiders ventured into one of Italy's most isolated regions, but nowadays it's easily reached by road and rail and regular low-cost flights into Pescara. With a third of its territory designated as national parks and nature reserves, Abruzzo is known as the greenest region in Europe. The number of foreign visitors has grown steadily since 2007. They come for the ski resorts, the wildlife sanctuaries, where wolves and bears still roam, and the 8 blue flag beaches. As Brits begin to be priced out of Tuscany, house hunters are turning their attention further south to Abruzzo and finding themselves very much in a buyer's market. This beautiful part of Italy is still relatively undiscovered. But tourism here is growing, alongside the number of foreign buyers entering the market. With the wealth of properties ripe for renovation, low prices and a strong exchange rate, now seems to be a great time to invest in an area which many predict will continue to grow in popularity. To get the lowdown on property in the region, I'm meeting estate agent Cristina Di Benigno. What's happening with property right now?
In the last 5 years, the market have been dropping. The prices are lower, about 30-35% since 2010.
Wow.
Yeah.
So does that mean there are bargains to be found here?
Yes, the bargains are in the countryside, where many owners want to get rid of old properties. And there are many properties available.
Really?
Yes.
So there's a lot of stock on the market. Does that mean people can negotiate on the asking price?
Yes.
Right.
Because many people need to sell.
It seems there could be plenty of opportunities here for Ali and Steve, especially if they're prepared to do a bit of work. So welcome back to Abruzzo, you two. How does it feel to be back?
It feels fabulous.
Yeah, I love it.
Beautiful.
Absolutely love it.
So tell me a bit about what you're looking for.
Probably about 6 bedrooms, or that can be made into 6 bedrooms. So two bedrooms for us and family, because we'll probably have millions of people coming over, and 4 bedrooms to rent out. A bit of land, if possible. You want to grow herbs.
Yeah, we'd like to grow vegetables, and we'd like to have a pool, obviously, to make the most of the weather.
So it's for a business, you're talking about.
Yeah, a B&B eventually is our sort of retirement package, isn't it, really?
Yeah. Let's talk about your budget. How much are you looking to spend out here?
Up to £100,000.
Where's that money coming from?
It's coming from the sale of my property in Ascot.
OK.
Which we've already sold.
Does that mean that you have the final say then, Ali?
Absolutely. We know it's going to be something that's going to need work. And to be honest, we want to turn it into our thing, so we don't want something that's been done already.
You both sound remarkably confident about this move and setting up a new business and the renovation project. Mm-hmm.
You could call it a dream, but to us it's reality. You know, it's something we've wanted to do for a long time.
I think we had better get started, don't you?
Yep.
Sounds like a good idea.
Yep.
Let's go.
As Ali and Steve want to set up their B&B halfway between coastal and ski resorts, I'm starting our search near the little town of Gesopelena in the foothills of the Majella mountain range. The word Gesso means chalk, and Gesopelena is built on a huge chalk reserve. Mining was the mainstay of the local economy until excavation started undermining the buildings. Just under 1,500 people live here, and nowadays 8% of them are foreigners, including a handful of Brits.
So our first stop off on the house hunt, I've brought you quite high up.
Yeah.
This town's called Gesopelena.
Got a nice vibe, isn't it?
It's got a nice feel.
Yeah.
And you've got all the usual amenities, everything you could need, you know, for your basic shopping and day-to-day stuff. Also, you've got the Majella National Park about 15 minutes away as well, which attracts a lot of tourists.
Mm, absolutely. I mean, you know, with the mountains and the sea and the national park, I mean, the kind of people that we want to attract, it'd be perfect for it. Yeah.
The property itself is about a 10-minute drive from here.
Estate agents have noticed that the number of foreign buyers scouting out this area is on the increase. And typically, the kind of home they're after is a traditional, detached, stone-built farmhouse with land. The first property I want to show Ali and Steve is just that, but it's a complete fixer-upper. So it'll be a good way to find out just how much work they're prepared to do.
Here we are. I'm hoping you're going to look at this and think, wow, look at the potential here. Mm-hmm.
The balconies look great.
What we've got is a 1950s build. Mm-hmm. At the moment, it's got three bedrooms.
Okay.
But you can see up there in the attic...
Mm. I was going to say, what's up there?
You've got potential to create further bedrooms up there. You've also got quite a lot of land,
okay,
which I'll show you.
That's good.
Out the back.
Okay.
And in a fantastic... Yeah, the scenic
views,
spot.
Yeah, the view's wonderful. I love it.
It needs pretty much complete renovation inside. It's on the market for just under £36,500.
No, it sounds even better.
Are you prepared for this, guys?
Yeah. Let's go for it.
Yeah?
This 1950s-built detached house set on the crest of a hill comes with 1¾ of an acre of land. Inside, it has a kitchen and storage room on the ground floor, which together have the potential to be converted into a large kitchen living room, plus there's a garage. Upstairs, there's a large dual-aspect master bedroom with a balcony, which would do for Ali and Steve, plus two other rooms that could be converted for B&B guests and a bathroom. At the top of the house, there's an attic with two further rooms, which could also be used for visitors. Lying empty since 1997, it needs just the kind of top-to-bottom refurbishment that Ali and Steve have set their hearts on, and it all comes at the bargain basement price of just under £36,500.
OK. Tell me what you think about this.
Oh, I love the fireplace.
It's small.
It is a bit too small, unless we can knock walls down and extend.
On the other side, you've got an additional room, which is a storage room at the moment, right, a wood store, but you could knock through there a door well, and have that as a living room or a breakfast room or whatever you wanted. Obviously, you've also got the garage there, so I don't know, you know, how you'd want to configure it or whether you could make it work. But
the problem is that, you know, the fireplace is fantastic. I wouldn't knock that down. You know, as part of the character.
I'm thinking, are we going to get enough rooms out of it? Enough bedrooms?
So you've got two bedrooms through there and a bathroom.
Mm-hmm.
And then you've got this bedroom also.
Okay.
Which, double aspect.
Yeah.
Front that's and back. Nice.
See the mountains in the background.
That's good.
That's a great view, isn't it?
Both of it. Beautiful. Is there a ensuite in
there? No ensuite. That leads to the stairs up to the attic.
Okay. If you have to come through this bedroom.
Mm. Yeah, obviously you'd have to reconfigure.
Yeah, we can spend a lot more money in configuring it the way we want it, but how much is it going to make it bigger? And we want that sort of slightly better than the normal B&B.
Now, the back out here, what you've got is 1¾ acres.
It's a beautiful spot.
Yeah, beautiful.
With the mountain backdrop. I'm feeling a bit disappointed, to be honest, that the house doesn't seem to have lived up to your ideals.
It's not quite there.
This place, it seems to be everything you want, but just on a smaller scale.
If it was just for the two of us, it would be fantastic.
This detached 1950s house with 1¾ acres of land is a project that needs complete refurbishment and is on the market for just under £36,500. Although Ali and Steve loved the hillside setting, it's disappointing that the house itself just didn't have enough space inside to accommodate the kind of upmarket B&B they're planning. Next, maybe an Italian country estate can come closer to Ali and Steve's dream.
How's this for a back garden?
Fantastic, absolutely fantastic.
Today, I'm house hunting in Italy with Ali Harris and Steve Ashby from Dorset. They're looking for a rural farmhouse that they can convert into a boutique bed and breakfast somewhere between the coast and the mountains here in the stunning region of Abruzzo.
My first offering was a detached 1950s house for sale at just under £36,500. It was exactly the kind of project they were looking for, but didn't offer quite enough space for the B&B. For our next property, I'm taking them on a 50-minute drive down towards the coast. Surrounded by vineyards, Vacri has been named as a Città del Vino, one of 39 historic Italian towns with proud traditions of gastronomy and winemaking.
We are now in Vacri, which is a really beautiful, picturesque village with spectacular views.
Unbelievable.
Beautiful. What do you two make of this location?
Oh, this is beautiful.
Goosebumps. It's
really?
Yeah,
it's really pretty.
I think there's plenty going on here as well. Like, in terms of your amenities, obviously you've got a couple of cafes, you've got restaurants. And as well as that, there are activities throughout the year going on. They've got an arts and crafts fair.
Oh,
there's a market every Sunday if you want to come and do your shopping.
Perfect.
The property is probably a 5-minute drive away from here.
House prices have always been higher in Vacri because it's in the commuter belt for two of the region's biggest towns, which is why a typical 3-4-bedroom farmhouse here starts at just over £65,000. For the next property, I want to show Ali and Steve something bigger that needs less renovation work, although it will push them much closer to the top of their £100,000 budget.
And this is the property.
Very nice.
There's still a bit of a project here, I'd say. But not as much as the last property.
No. Okay. No. If it saves time in some way and saves money, then perfect.
It's on the market for just over £98,500.
Okay.
So still within budget.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
But here, at least, you can come straight away, start having holidays.
Yeah.
You can have friends and family out here immediately.
I like the location and the kind of the fact that it's good to go, in a way, that is a good thing, even though we like to do our own thing.
This renovated bungalow is set within over an acre of land. Inside, an airy entrance hall leads to an open-plan kitchen, diner and living room. There's further space in the two enclosed verandas, one of which is currently being used as a tool shed and garage. With three double bedrooms and one very spacious bathroom, the property is on the market for just over £98,500.
Lovely big entrance hall.
I can see what you're saying about almost moving in instantly.
All the furniture is included, apart from a few personal items.
Yeah.
Okay. This is a lovely big space, isn't it?
Wow, yeah.
It sort of screams out for being guests. Breakfast room, sitting room.
I definitely think it should be, you know, more of a sitting area around there and then for the dining area around there.
Let's have a look in this bedroom.
Nice size room, actually.
It is, and it's really lovely and bright. At the moment, none of the bedrooms are en suite. Okay. So I know that's not what you want for a B&B.
It's not configured the way we want it to be, but it's doable.
Now, this is a great spot for storing everything. It's really big. What do you reckon you could fit in here?
At least two decent-sized bedrooms.
Yeah.
And probably en-suites as well.
Absolutely.
So, how's this for a back garden? Wow,
yeah. Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. Little mountains. You can imagine in the wintertime with the snow over there would be beautiful, absolutely beautiful. And you've got the town just there.
Do you want to go and have a little wander, take it all in, and I'll catch up with you afterwards?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
See you in a moment.
Thanks very much. That's quite a decent sized bathroom.
It's a very big bathroom.
Isn't it?
Yeah. A lovely room.
Yeah.
It's almost a shame to split it up.
Yeah, I know, but it doesn't fill our needs, does it? That's the problem. Possibilities are great, especially when you've got this area as well.
Yeah, we could definitely use that area.
And then this bedroom, I think, looking at it, it's probably going to be our room.
Yeah, it would make sense.
It would
make
sense.
With the kitchen behind, you don't want people disturbed by kitchen noises.
This renovated bungalow with three bedrooms and over an acre of land is in good decorative order, but there's plenty of scope for Ali and Steve to make it their own. On the market for just over £98,500, it's made the couple realise the advantages of a place they could move into immediately.
So, what are you two thinking now you've had some time to wander around?
It really is a lovely property.
Mm.
It's got definite potential.
Absolutely.
It wasn't our vision, you know, if we look in our heads and say, is this the kind of place that we thought we were looking for? But it's kind of changed our perception.
Absolutely. Because I know that we could reconfigure it exactly how we want it.
So where do we go from here then in terms of what you'd like to see next?
Quite like to see a two-storey rather than a single storey.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this one's in the running.
Absolutely, yeah.
Perfect.
Okay.
While Ali and Steve are planning to run their own B&B, the move to Italy isn't just about business.
I had a heart attack in 2010. Before then, my lifestyle was not very good food. What Ali did was put me onto a much better diet. I lost weight. I'm much healthier. But I think coming here will give me longevity, give me a number of years to spend with this lady. We want to grow old, not gracefully, but we do want to grow old
outrageously.
Together. Outrageously, yes.
Any plans for wedding number five?
I did say to Ali, she bought me a lovely bottle of champagne a couple of years ago.
Mm.
And we were going to open it then. I said, no, let's wait. Why don't we open it when you marry me when I'm 70 in our garden in Italy? She hasn't... Have you answered that yet?
No.
I
answered that nearer the time. He's had four marriages before. Everything's good now. Why do I need to get married?
Yeah.
We've got each other. What else do you need?
Coming up, Ali and Steve are surprised in a good way.
Bit of a curveball.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This makes complete financial sense.
Today, I'm helping Ali Harris and Steve Ashby realise their dream of opening a B&B in Italy. With a cash budget of £100,000, they're hoping to find a property with at least two bedrooms and the potential to create more in the future.
So far, we've shown them this detached 1950s house with fabulous views. On the market for just under £36,500, it was the kind of complete refurbishment project Ali and Steve had requested, but just wasn't big enough inside for their dream B&B. This renovated bungalow on the market for just over £98,500 was much more spacious and ready to move in, making Ali and Steve wonder if they should steer clear of a project altogether. I'm hoping my next property will help them decide whether they're prepared to take on a complete refurbishment. We're driving 15 minutes north and even nearer to the coast. Lipa Teatina's unique claim to fame is having produced the champion boxers Rocky Mattioli, who was born here, and Rocky Marciano, whose father emigrated to America from the town.
So we have now come to a slightly bigger town called Lipa Teatina. What are your first impressions, both of you?
Yeah, I like it. It's nice.
Nice town.
I love the church.
That is the church of San Pietro Apostolo.
Okay.
And that's the main church in the area.
Right.
You've got around just over 4,000 residents here. Okay. So it is a little bit bigger, mm-hmm. 8 of whom are British.
Really?
Okay.
Obviously, it is predominantly an Italian community here. Is that really what you want to be part of?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. Want to be part of the local community.
Yeah, get involved, you know, understand the culture.
The property itself is about 5 minutes from here.
Okay.
Though it's close to the sea, Ripa Teatina still attracts very few foreign buyers. That's partly because the majority of properties in this area were built in the 1970s and 80s, and apart from in the town centre, there are very few of the old-style traditional properties that are so popular with Brits.
Here we are then. Now, the property we're looking at is actually this one in front of us here.
Okay.
Built around late 50s.
Okay.
And does need quite a lot of work.
We would probably change the front of it, the look yeah. of it.
It might not look much from out here, but believe me, this place has got masses of potential. The house here is on the market for just under £95,000. Mm-hmm. I just think for the potential here, it's worth a look mm-hmm. and maybe worth a punt for you
too. Okay, yeah.
From the front, this house appears to be a single floor, but because it's set into the hillside, it's much more spacious than it looks. At the top, there's a large kitchen, a reception room, 2 bedrooms and 1 bathroom. The lower level contains 6 more rooms, all of which need renovating, and the whole package comes for an asking price of just under £95,000. Next door is a building which has recently been inherited by a cousin of the owner of the main house, who's willing to sell it for around £14,500 once he's sorted out the paperwork.
We're going to start off in the kitchen.
Good size.
It is good size, isn't it?
So when you're not working, once you do move out here and you've got the business up and running, what else do you think you'll be doing with your time? Do you have hobbies that you'd like to take up?
Well, we like cycling, walking, but again, with the town so near, we would immerse ourselves in the culture of the town. It's such a beautiful area.
There's exactly.
So many places to explore.
And this is your sort of main reception room. At the moment, dining and sitting room.
Yeah,
I mean, it could be a lovely dining room.
Yeah. Are both of you quite good at being able to see past things like decor and furniture? And,
yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, mm-hmm. We look at the floor plans rather than, you know, so for potential of what you could do with it yeah. rather than what is there.
So, we have got 2 really lovely sized bedrooms.
Oh, wow.
Okay. It's not talking to me as much as the previous property.
Now, come and have a look at this.
Oh, wow.
That's amazing.
That's incredible.
Under this house, you've got a lower ground floor, which you could convert into some more usable space. Do you want to have a look downstairs and see the rest?
Yeah. Mm.
And then meet me again out front.
Yeah.
Okay.
Have another bedroom with an ensuite.
Yeah, it's a self-contained unit, isn't it? Both of them self-contained. The potential is here.
Yeah.
I understand that.
It's too big a project, I think.
This hillside house has wonderful views and masses of potential. There are currently 2 bedrooms, but there are several others that could be developed on the lower floor, all for an asking price of just under £95,000.
Love it or hate it.
Don't hate it. No, I don't love it.
No. Oh, not feeling the love.
No. The time it would take and the amount of money.
Seeing something that's already renovated can be more cost effective than looking at a ruin and then spend all the money and the time doing it up.
And instead of a 5-year plan, it's a 2.5-year plan.
Given your reactions here, it's worth showing you something more along those lines.
Yeah.
Would you agree?
Yeah, absolutely. I think that'd be good.
As Ali and Steve seem to be coming round to the idea of a property which has already been refurbished, I'm taking them further south to the town of Cherni. With a good range of shops and a weekly market, there are also a number of fairs here throughout the year, celebrating different saints, plus every August there's the famous snail festival.
This is called Cherni. Really what this town is all about is food.
Mm-hmm.
Good.
Yes, we like food.
It's a real foodie area, and it's very well known for its olives and a type of salami that's produced here. And they have lots of seasonal cakes and baking. I know you're quite into baking, aren't you? Mm. They make a Christmas cake here that is a speciality. So the property we're looking at is about 10 minutes out of town.
Being near the sea means property in the Chernihiv area is expensive, with a farmhouse in good condition starting at about £125,000. Foreign house hunters are attracted to the area by the nearby Punta Aderci Nature Reserve on the coast.
Now, this place is something a bit different.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wow.
First impressions.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Very nice.
What we've got here is a completely restored two-bedroom house.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Both bedrooms are very big. Both bedrooms are en suite.
Okay.
And upstairs, you've got a separate one-bedroom apartment.
Okay.
Okay.
There's already foundations, power supply and water supply for the swimming pool to be installed.
Okay.
I like it.
What I was thinking is, if you were to buy this, you could potentially start getting an income straight away.
Mm.
Letting upstairs.
Mm-hmm.
It is a bit over budget.
How much over budget?
It's on the market for around £120,000.
Okay.
But the owner has said that's very negotiable.
Okay.
And that's come straight from the horse's mouth.
Okay. Okay.
So there's a very good chance that you could get it close to your budget.
Okay. Yeah.
Bit of a curveball.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This makes complete financial sense.
Actually, with this one, I'm going to let you have a look around on your own.
Okay.
So that you can digest everything. And good luck.
This property, standing in an acre of land with olive trees, has been refurbished to a very high standard. Downstairs, there's a living room with an exposed stone feature wall that leads to an ensuite double bedroom. There's also a kitchen diner with its own cloakroom, leading to a second ensuite double bedroom. The upstairs apartment has its own entrance via an outside staircase. It has one double bedroom and a shower room, plus a room that can be fitted out as a kitchen living room. The whole property is on the market for just under £120,500.
This is nice.
Oh, wow.
Nice exposed brick.
That's beautiful, isn't it?
It's a bedroom.
Oh, wow. I can see us here.
Yeah.
You know?
It's nice and bright.
Yeah.
It's a nice country feel to it.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Not sure about the green, but nice, isn't it?
Yeah, lovely scenery. Natural wood. It's a nice shower.
It just needs painting. That's all it does.
Yeah, bit of paint.
It doesn't need anything else, really. Again, like Jasmine said, you can just really move
in. Pretty much in.
Yeah, we wouldn't have to do anything. It's not like the last property. We would have to spend thousands and thousands. That would be a big project.
Mm.
Here, we spend
small
thousands,
details.
But the thousands will be spent on just getting it to a stage that we want, and also the swimming
finishing
pool outside.
It off,
yes, finishing it off.
Plenty of space for at least two cars.
Yeah, even more probably, if you think about it.
Good size room.
For the bedroom, perfect, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Great view.
Beautiful views.
Oh, imagine waking up to that. There's the living room and the kitchen.
This is nice.
You could have a nice little compact kitchen over there, couldn't you?
Yeah.
And the shower room. Yeah, shower
nicely room. Nicely done as well.
And again, wherever you look, you've got the views as well, haven't you?
Beautiful.
Yeah. Out of all of them, I think this is financially and for that time.
Makes sense.
It makes big sense. I like it.
This house with a separate apartment has a total of three bedrooms and three bathrooms. On the market for just under £120,500, it offers Ali and Steve the possibility of an immediate rental income and has gone straight to the top of their list.
And what do you think of the property?
It's definitely given us food for thought.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's, you know, where we would spend all that money here, it's 95% done.
Mm. So this is win-win.
Oh, yeah.
It seems so.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad I took a risk and showed it to you.
Thank you.
I really am.
Thank you.
Now I'm slightly torn about what to show you for our final property, because I did have something in mind that's quite different, but could be really interesting again.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Different's good. Mm.
I've got goosebumps here.
Ooh, I wonder if that's a sign.
Coming up, a property sets Steve's pulse racing.
Come on, Steve, tell us what's going on. Your heart pounding.
Yeah, everything's pounding.
Ali Harris and Steve Ashby live busy lives in Dorset, but as they get closer to retirement age, they plan on swapping the UK for the Abruzzo region of Italy. They're looking for a rural property in need of renovation that they can transform into a B&B.
They originally thought they wanted a project, so I took them to this detached 1950s house in the mountains. On the market for just under £36,500, it turned out not to be spacious enough. Next Stop provided them with more room, a bungalow already renovated to a high standard, priced at just over £98,500. This place was ready to move into, making them think they might want something with less work. So it didn't surprise me that they ruled out the hillside house with an asking price of just under £95,000 because it was too big a project. The house with a separate apartment reinforced their preference for something already renovated. On the market for just under £120,500, its quality finish went down well, and the unexpected possibility of immediate rental income prompted a bit of a rethink. While Ali and Steve seem to be leaning away from refurbishment, I'm still going to show them my final property. It might be a place that needs doing up, but it comes with lots of renovation plans and help at hand. I'm taking them to the tiny village of Fallo, in a mountainous area near to the Majella National Park.
Dare I say it, another gorgeous little hilltop village. What do you two make of this location?
It's a really lovely little village, really well cared for. Looks beautiful.
It is a lot smaller, this village. Only 133 people living
here.
Okay.
How many Brits?
No Brits.
Hopefully within a few months we know everybody's names.
Although it's very tiny, you've still got all the basics here. So you've got a post office, you've got a bar, a little grocery store.
Since the 1950s, the village's population has shrunk as young people move away to find work. But there are moves afoot to reverse the trend, and I'm about to show Ali and Steve how they could play their part.
That is all of what we're looking at.
All of that?
All of it.
It's a lovely building.
Absolutely. Another curveball, I think.
Another curveball. And this one's a bit different because what the local town hall are trying to do is bring life back into the village. So they've managed to trace the original owners, reclaim these old properties that have been abandoned for 50 or more years, and are now developing them, selling them off, and then want to encourage people to come and live here and start businesses here. Mm. So you are exactly the kind of people they want to encourage.
Okay.
You will have the support of the local town, the local architect, who's actually done some costings for the project as well.
Great.
And they've got craftsmen, builders, labourers, they've got everybody here on hand, ready to go. They just need the finance.
Structurally, it looks fantastic, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. It's amazing from the outside.
It's on the market for just over £25,500.
No! You're joking.
And they've got a price that they think it would take to do up?
The ballpark figure that the town architect has put on this to do the work, to the same standard as the other property that they've done, is around £90,000.
Okay.
That's more than a curveball, Jasmine. That's more than a curveball. It really is. It's like...
Is it another spanner in the works?
Yeah.
You okay?
Yeah.
Come on, Steve, tell us what's going on. Your heart pounding.
Everything's pounding.
This row of five stone houses is around 150 years old and is in need of complete refurbishment. But it's part of a scheme backed by the local mayor to bring life back into the village. On the market for just over £25,500, the five houses currently have five bedrooms, but the interiors could be reconfigured to suit the needs of Ali and Steve's B&B. It has a small garden, and there's also some more land at the rear that could be bought separately for just over £3,500.
Come on in through these beautiful doors. Obviously, it needs everything.
Yes.
Doing.
Yeah. Still not daunting. I mean, if anything, I love the shape of this room.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, this is what we've been looking for, isn't it?
Mm. I mean, it is a complete tip.
What do you think your kids would say about the two
I
properties
think they'd
we've seen?
We were completely nuts if we took this on board.
Really?
Yeah.
But then we are. So it's our future.
Okay. This is the bigger of the two bedrooms.
It's small.
It's small.
You've got a smaller bedroom next door with a bathroom. Mm-hmm. Maybe you could just make this one big bedroom up here with a bathroom.
Just love those stairs. You can imagine them all cleaned up and shining. And
yeah, it's their project, isn't it?
I'll let you two go and have an explore. And then when you're finished, come and meet me at number 95, which is the property that's already been renovated by the council.
Well,
I like that. Look at this.
The shape of that arch.
This could be the living room. You know what? If you imagine opening all that out, just to have that arch there, just glass, it is exactly what we wanted, isn't it?
Yeah. Lovely fireplace in here again.
Ceiling is incredible, isn't it? Imagine if we cleaned all that up.
Yeah. This could be a downstairs sitting room and maybe a kitchen area at the back.
Yeah.
This is a climb and a half.
Yeah. You could actually build like a, not decking, but something really
like
cool.
A terraced area. Look at those views.
I know, it's incredible, isn't it?
Yeah.
This hamlet of five stone-built properties is a complete renovation project with huge potential. On the market for just over £25,500, it's part of a rebuilding scheme that has the backing of the local council and community.
I wanted to show you this place. This behind us is the building that the council have already completed. Okay. You can see they've done loads of work to the beautiful stairs here. What did you two think of it?
It seems to have enough room space for the B&B.
Yeah, absolutely. Or even self-contained flats, couldn't it? There's more to think about now.
So, shall we head back?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And I'll leave you two to have a good old think.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
We've shown Ali and Steve five houses for their budget of £100,000. They set out with the idea of finding a renovation project, but ruled out two straight away. Although they could see the potential in a 1950s detached house for just under £36,500, they felt the internal space was just too small. And they felt a hillside house for just under £95,000 was too much of a project for them to take on. The bungalow with a huge garden at an asking price of just over £98,500 made Ali and Steve realise they didn't have to do all the work themselves, while the house with the apartment being offered for just under £120,500 gave them the chance to start letting the top floor straight away. And finally, the stone hamlet on the market for just over £25,500 seemed to have all the potential to fulfil their original dream. I can't wait to find out what they've decided.
When we left each other yesterday, it seemed like there were still three potential contenders. Mm-hmm. One was that renovated bungalow, which needed some reconfiguration.
Yeah.
But, you know, seemed like it had possibilities.
Mm-hmm. We've discounted that one, haven't we?
Have you?
Yeah. Yeah, I think because of the price of it...
And... together with the amount of changes that we would need to do and obviously the cost of that.
So you've narrowed it down to two properties, our final two, which, to be fair, couldn't be more different from one another, could
they? Completely different. I thought it would be an easy decision. I thought that, you know, we knew exactly what we wanted, which to a certain extent we do, but we hadn't thought through the options of having a place already renovated.
It's starting to get a bit tantalising now because it sounds like you may be leaning towards the house with the apartment. Come on, tell me, what does it come down to?
At the end of the day, it comes down to the land. We looked at their renovation project for hours.
Yeah.
Because it would be so beautiful, it would be so fantastic to have the backup of the community.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, the worry was that the land at the back would be too steep. It was important to us to have a proper size pool. Mm.
Yeah, that takes it away from that in a sense. And I think the property that's already been renovated, that gives us that, doesn't it? Now we could put a swimming pool in.
So have you made the decision?
Go on.
Yes. We are going to go for the renovated property.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so pleased.
The beauty of it is literally we could retire earlier. Mm-hmm. We could rent it out for 3 or 4 years.
Until we were ready to move out there.
Yeah.
Do you feel like you're ready to make an offer?
I think we can.
Yeah.
Have you got an idea of how much you'd like to offer? Because obviously it's on the market for around £120,500.
About 105, 106.
So say £106,000?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Ciao, hello Miller, it's Jasmine. I've got some brilliant news for you. Ali and Steve want to make an offer on the house we looked at in Cherni. They would like to offer £106,000. So you'll get back to me once you've spoken to the owner? Brilliant, thank you very much, Mila. I'll speak to you soon.
Okay.
Okay.
Gotta wait now.
Right, fingers crossed, everything crossed. Hi, Miller. Hold on 1 second for me. Can you hold? The agent says that the owner's not willing to accept £106,000, but he will accept £109,500.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hi, Miller.
I think we can do that.
Yes, that's great. We've got a deal. Okay. Yes, that's perfect. Thank you very much. Wow! Are you okay? I mean, how are you feeling right now?
Unbelievable. You haven't lost for words.
Yeah, I know. It's not normal, is it? Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Jasmine.
Yeah, thank you, Jasmine, for the curveball, which turned out as a good ball. You okay? Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Cheers, guys. It's
Cheers.
Wonderful news.
Thank you.
I'm so pleased for you.
Cheers.
Congratulations. This is such a big moment for Ali and Steve. For 5 years, they've been planning every detail of this move, and now they've found the perfect property, which is nothing like what they'd originally imagined. But I'm certain they've made the right decision, and I couldn't be happier for them.
Since returning home, Ali and Steve have hit a delay in completing on the sale of their house in Ascot. They're working hard to get all the paperwork in place so that they can finalise the purchase of their dream house in Abruzzo in good time.